the elves are back. We got our jobs back. Thanks to this guy, number 297. He got our jobs back. Yeah.
Yay.
Roll the bumper.
Are proper.
bit more taste. Let's see what we think about. Then the next time we're gonna taste, we're gonna try it with a salty pack. It's actually a really tasty beer.
Yeah.
And it, oh, we didn't even say the alcohol by volume. See, this is why Nick didn't hire us. And we had to go back to the North Pole. So, what salty snack should we do? Peanut or pretzel? You're choosing. I'm gonna do peanut. Peanut. Pour this guy in here again. Yeah. Right? These are adorable little glasses! Ta-da! Okay. I'm gonna try some really nice world gold pretzels. Salty snack done? Yeah. Let's see what we got for taste now. Yeah. Wow, it really mellowed out the hobby. Did it mellow it out for you? That was peanut. That was peanut. It made it more hoppy. Yeah? Made it more. Yeah, because the bread and the pretzels really mellowed it out. So it'll taste more mellow?
Yeah.
Pretzel? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Salty stack number 2.
Oh, yeah. No, it does.
Yep, that brought back bitterness.
You can tell the difference.
Wow. So that's something new. You little bitches that mixed in. You didn't know this. But the different salty snack can change.
Right. So now I just had a pretzel instead of peanut.
It's more mellow than that.
Yeah. The bread from the pretzel that kind of helps it.
See, take that. That's what you get for firing us, but we're not going to tell you.
The mixed-in guys always did Snyder's pretzels.
Yeah,
that's true.
Just mixing it up with peanuts. They only did one thing at a time. They either did the pretzels or they did the nuts, which means they didn't get an accurate testing of the proper salty snack. I totally forgot what I was going to say. Hey, Ludo. Yes, we stole him from me. Okay, so,
I think he wants beer.
That was mine, right? I don't know, what do you think about the salty snack in it?
I think it tastes pretty good with the...
Yeah. I think it's even. I think it's either with or without it. Each salty snack kind of does its own little thing. Weird how the pretzel actually calms down the hoppiness a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And the peanuts enhance it.
It's
so it's kind of interesting. But it, at the end of all of it, it all has the same nice dark lager taste to it.
Yep.
It's very enjoyable.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like a whole bunch. It's kind of like, I like the balance. They did it really good.
Yes.
And then trying it with a salty snack, I
prefer the pretzel. Maybe you don't, unless you want it to taste more bitter, then have a peanut. Other than that, slamming it tasted even like more powerful. So like put a whole bunch of it over your taste buds. Really good. So I give it a big thumbs up.
All right. Right there. Oh, there's a finger in my face.
So, I have to agree with 1405
over here. 1407, I think.
Yeah,
1407.
1405
is his cousin. I have to agree with him because the fact that, yes, I love loggers. I absolutely love them. And, especially winter loggers, because you never know what you're going to get with them, honestly. I've had from here to there, longer after longer. But this one was pretty good because it was not as bitter as you thought it would be, honestly. But yeah, I would have to give it a huge thumbs up.
Ooh, all right. Big ol' thumbs up.
Oh yeah. Because of the fact that it did.
Alright, so I agree. I think it's a very relaxing dark lager. It has a great taste to it. It has a little bit of the hops to it, but it's not like overpowering. Yeah. But now what I'm about to tell you guys is going to be like kind of shocking.
What?
Okay. But all in all, I do. The look of it looks really nice. The smell of it, nice aroma of poppy, and the taste of it is really nice, mellow. I tasted something different when we downed it faster.
Yeah.
Which is makes me want to do that again for some strange reason. Multiple times, over and over and over again. Yes. But besides that, I give it a big old thumbs up also.
Yay!
I thought So, what the website has to say about this beer is... Oops, I missed that one. Okay. Winter Hook is Red Hook's legendary winter ale, brewed annually since 1984.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Crafted with an invoking mix of malt and hops. Each yearly edition of Winter Hook is one of a kind. This year's incarnation, crafted by header brewer Nick Crandall. Is a hoppy dark lager, combining the hops of a dank art IPA, the malts of a brown ale, and the yeast profile of a bock.
Ooh, nice.
So, yeah, that's why it has that really interesting taste to it. It's like, we can't quite place that somewhere because it has all those different tastes inside of it. That's awesome. Winter Hook's dark color and bold flavors make a perfect winter warmer for frosty weather. I agree 100%. I would love to drink this beer when it's nice and go outside, nice and cold.
Yeah, it's really cold.
Yeah, the snow's coming down.
Alcohol
by volume is 6%, which we already said.
The IBU, Chris, can you guess what the IBU is?
I'm gonna guess that there's so much hops in there, it's gonna be high. Like, 60? Damn.
Wow!
Right on the nose!
Nice! Yeah.
Yep, right on the nose. 60 IBU. Right on. So, I guess we should have read this stuff at the beginning of the beer review. But hey, this makes you wait till the end.
Yeah.
So you don't just...
Yeah.
Well, if you like that kind of a thing, then subscribe to Mixed In. Give it a shot. That's the category that we, the playlist we got here. And, we still sell them our videos to put up on their website.
Yeah. And then you should go buy their stuff, because their shirts and stuff is cool.
Yeah, they're pretty cool.
I got a shirt last year from Mixed In employee Chris. It's a nice shirt.
He's a good guy. Oh, the Peace Brains. Yeah, you can make them in the description below. I'll figure that out. But right now, there's still the Cafe Press, all of our other Mixed In products there. And yeah, so thanks for watching. And hey, there's more stuff like this coming, that's for sure. So we'll see you next time. Yeah, Elf's on the way out.